สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome back to Bim's Kitchen. I've been working hard over last week to prepare my panettone. Actually, it's just the dough and the ingredient itself that I prepare. I have La Vita Merde from last year and I refreshed about 3 times before I've been using it. And today I'm going to show you how I make my amazing panettone. Okay, this is how to refresh La Vita Madre. Actually, you need to refresh 3 times. But I run out of time and my La Vita Madre just been feeding or refresh last week. So I just gonna do 2 times instead. The ingredient for my La Vita Madre for this refreshment, I have 120 grams of my La Vita Madre, and I have 50 grams of water and 100 grams of bread flour. So it's a mix together. It's gonna be really stiff dough. So when you mix stiff dough instead of knead by hand, it's really impossible to make them knead together well. So I use a rolling pin. That is a technique from all the chef that I've been watched. So you use a rolling pin to roll it out thin, and the between each roll you have to wait a little bit to make sure that dough is relaxed and the gluten is relaxed before you roll it again. And then after you roll it out a couple of times, at least about 6 times, then you need to make it a long strip and roll it out nice and tight. And don't forget to close the seam. And when you put into the bath, they're not open it up. And you have a very nice round La Vita Madre ready to put into the bath. So all you need to do is just find the big water cup and then drop the La Vita Madre in there for 4 hours. So this is after 4 hours, you just drain the water out. You need to put in the water about 28 degrees Celsius for about 4 hours. This is after 4 hours. And then you just drain the water out and mix your last refreshment. For the last refreshment, I have all La Vita Madre that I make from first time, first refreshment. And then I have 80 grams of water and 160 grams of bread flour. Again, you need to make sure you measure everything right or correct to make sure that your La Vita Madre working well, you know, create a beautiful, perfect result. I'm gonna write ingredient into the detail later, so you can refer to amount of everything in my writing ingredient. So when you mix the dough, make sure you break the La Vita Madre apart, because it's gonna be easy to knead. Remember, it's really stiff dough. So you roll about 5 or 6 times, and then you come back to rolling La Vita Madre again. Again, you need to bath them. This time the dough is quite big, so you need a big container to bath them. This is after 4 hours in 28 degrees Celsius. We are ready to make the first dough. For the ingredient of the first dough, I will write it down for you. Basically, we need 600 grams of bread flour and 300 grams of water, 165 grams of sugar. Mix everything together, sugar, water, and bread flour, and of course, 150 grams of La Vita Madre, and mix this 4 ingredients together first until you have a really, really nice, and the gluten has developed very well for this stage. Okay, the key is you have to pass that step first before you add 150 grams of egg yolk. You add 3 times you know, you cut into three times and add into three times. After you add the egg yolk, and then you got until the dough is become like sticky like that. This is the most important. If your dough is not sticky like that, don't add the butter, because butter gonna stop gluten development if it's not gluten not strengthened or not strong enough. So I add the butter in three times, little bit by little bit. So you can see that my small pot working very well. Actually, I should add the room temperature butter, but anyway, I am still learning as well. So I add three times, and until this is my pot, until the dough become really, really nice, shiny, sticky. And of course, I always check the window pane test. This is the most important part. I am so difficult to get the window pane test for this pot because it's so small. And also I check temperature. It needs to be 25 degrees Celsius. The dough, it should not be too hot. So I turn on the aircon. So my pot is become cold, so when I mix dough, my dough is 25 degrees Celsius. And then after that, you have gluten developed, your dough is very sticky and shiny. So go ahead to put on the counter and start to mix by hand again. Because you know, when you mix with the stand mixer, there will be some part that not mix very well. So hand mix is always the best. So I use, this is the wet dough. After all, you add all the ingredient, or the egg, or the butter, water. So this dough is, I think it's about 80% hydration. By my experience, I didn't really measure it. So of course, I use the slap and fold technique to make sure all the dough is mixed together well. This is very, very nice and relaxing to working with the very shiny and wet dough. Again, after I slap and fold, I then check the gluten. So I have very nice window pane test. And then I gonna put into the container. It need to be big container because they're gonna rise up about three times during our proofing. The first dough needs to be proofed about 12 hours at room temperature, about 25 to 28 degrees Celsius. This is the dough after 12 hours. We're gonna make second dough. For the second dough, of course, we need all the first dough together with 150 grams of bread flour, 260 grams of mandarin paste, 100 grams of butter, 115 grams of egg yolk. I have 130 grams of sugar, 8 grams of salt, 30 grams of honey, 335 grams of raisin soaking into the water, 155 grams of candies, orange and lemon peel, and one vanilla pot. So after we prepare the vanilla, we just drop our first dough into the pot and add the flour. Just the first dough and flour. And then you, if you have a stand mixer, use that. I don't have one, so I have the bread mixer. So the stand mixer will be working quicker. If you have stand mixer, try to mix the bread, flour, and the first dough together about 20 minutes. So after 20 minutes, your dough will be really elastic and the gluten has developed. So like that. After the gluten have developed, you add the mandarin paste and make sure you don't break the gluten. So that's why we use the mandarin paste first before candy or dry fruit, because the mandarin paste is really like a paste. It's not like chunky. And then again, I add egg three times, you know, little by little at a time. And then after the gluten has developed well, I shake my dough. That one I add salt and sugar. After my dough is developed the gluten well, then later on I add the butter. Again this time, I don't forget to make sure that my butter is room temperature, and mix the dough. I forgot to add the sugar, so I just add it. So mix the dough with the butter about three times. Like I said, the butter should not add before the gluten has developed. So again, I check my gluten development. I have a window pane test, pass the window pane test. So then I can go ahead and mix with the chunky part, which is my lemon peel candies and dry, what you call, dry raisin. The raisin I've been soaking into the water for overnight and squeeze the water out, so I don't want any extra water into my dough. Actually, if you have a stand mixer, you can mix the orange and lemon peel candies together with raisin in the mixer, but my pot or my mixer is too small. So I use this technique, is called lamination technique. I just, you know, folding the dough together with the dry fruit, and then do it, flip it many times. So that's why your dough is. And then I just rest the dough for 2 hours on the countertop. Don't forget to cover. The Italian chef told me that if you have a bubble on the dough, so your dough is gonna be perfect. So I had that, I'm happy about that. And then I go ahead and look at the mud, what I have. I have three different kind of muds, and this one is like 1 kilogram each, so 70 gram each. So I cut the dough into three different parts. It depends on what mud you have, you know. You don't have to worry, oh, how many gram exactly. You just look at the mud and put about one part, you know. You, for example, 1 out of 3 part into the pot, into any mud that you have. So they're gonna rise about double or triple time. So you can imagine what mod you're gonna use and make sure that your dough gonna rise triple. Okay, so this is a very important, I learned from Italian chef. After you cut the dough out, you just need to pre-shape it tight, because the dough is so wet. So I use bent scraper to shape like that. I don't know what the name of the shape technique, but this is the way. Make sure that your dough is strengthen the surface of the dough. I don't know what the name of that technique. Just follow my technique. After the dough very nice and tight, you just drop them into the molds. So you see that they sit in the bottom of the molds, so the dough will be rise three times, remember that. So, and then again, this is the technique. So you can't skip this part. This is the way to make your dough rise nice. Not just cut the dough and drop, you know. You need to shape like your normal sourdough bread, you know. That is how to strengthen the gluten before you put into the mud. This is the final shape, same as the first shape. You know, the pre-shape, after you pre-shape, you wait 30 minutes before final shape. So let them rise in the room temperature about 4 hours to 6 hours, depend on your room temperature. I have about 6 hours to be fully rise. So I make so many batch. I have different style of the mod. So let's prove the dough. about 4 or 6 hours after. Now you use your bread, bread to score. Just score the mark on, you know, cross on the top, and then put one knob of butter. Sometimes you can, you know, open up and put the knob of butter by the side. That's gonna be done too. So gonna let your dough rising up nicely. And you can use the sugar to put on the top as well. So another one I'm gonna show you. I just use my normal bread to score, and then I put one knob of butter onto the top. So this way the dough will be rise up nice after you baking. Okay, so then go ahead to put into the preheat oven at 185 degrees Celsius at least 1 hour before you baking your panettone. I use convection oven, so the air circulation of the oven is go everywhere, so I can have a bake on the bottom and on the top too. So this way I don't have to rotate my panettone. Remember, you cannot open the door during your baking, otherwise your panettone will be sinking immediately. I make that mistake. So after you take it out, you can see the dough, the bread is sinking. So go ahead and put the skewer in to the pot, and put into the to the pot immediately. The reason I put in the pot first, because if it's dropping, or if it's not baked properly, it's dropping, it can fall into the pot. But I check my panettone is working well, a very strong one. Let's see my panettone. This thing, my son make it for me to hang my panettone. Star panettone. First thing I checked this morning is any of my panettone falling into the tray. I am lucky, none of them falling. So it's worked. There you go. This is the final products. I have a different kind of panettone. The crumb is nice and beautiful, and the taste is so yummy. This is exciting moment. We're gonna cut it open and see how it looks inside. So I prepare the cutting board here, and we're gonna see it together how it looks like. This is so amazing. Wow. Let's try it together. OMG, you're gonna try it. This is so light, so fluffy. It's just like cotton. Try some. Good?
Good.
Amazing. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoy my video, and Let's make panettone together. สวัสดีค่ะ This is so amazing. Can't stop eating it. Delicious. I'm gonna give it to my friend.